This sucks.
Hey, Keith, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Good afternoon, fellas. I wanted to know if, by any chance, if Fez has a time limit as to how long before he starts to bully somebody around today that can't defend themselves.
Why do you have to call and start shit first thing in the morning? People get mad when Fez bullies people, and then they get mad when he doesn't talk. And he's getting to the point where he doesn't know what to do anymore. Oh. Sometimes he'll just spend time in the hall.
Yeah, well.
Now, I want to ask him about his shrink last night, but I have no idea how it went.
Can I guess? Make a guess?
Yeah.
I think it went well last night.
You think it ended up being happy?
Yeah.
I will always bet against that. That, you know what I mean?
I have a dollar that he didn't cry last night.
A dollar?
I have a dollar. Oh, where is
it? I'll give you odds on it. Hans, you're on the run of fate.
No one.
Thank you, Chris. Normally you're against me.
Well, sometimes, you know, crazy shit's happening in here.
What kind of odds you want on your dollar bet?
10-1.
Let's go 1,000,000-1.
Okay. I'll take it. Look, I like a long shot. I like a crazy bet.
I'll do the million. To me, it's like I bet a gravity exists. That's how fucking sure I know you're throwing away that fucking George of yours.
I gotta find the dollar. Hold on.
Just light it on fire. Don't even give it to me. Light it on fire and hold it till it burns your fingers.
I just have a feeling that he didn't cry last night.
Why?
I don't know. He came in not too perturbed this morning.
You know why?
Why?
He had a good cry last night. I'm sure of it. Why would Watley even have a shrink if he couldn't cry there?
I don't know. He cries in here sometimes.
Yeah. He cries in here on days he has to work. Yesterday he loved because he was in the hallway.
For a while. Yeah, I don't even have a dollar, man. That was bullshit.
You can owe me.
Okay.
What's going over at Shade 45? There's fucking posse coming out of there. What's it, pizza day?
It actually is pizza day, Ron. They had their Domino's like 10 minutes ago.
Sure. Everybody gets singles. Make sure you bring that up to your buddy Blackface.
Will do.
Why black guys won't split a pizza.
What's Blackface's problem? Why won't he split a pizza with Pips?
Well, that entire thing made me laugh because I thought to myself, well, why do white people, is it the one food that we're okay with splitting?
It's because it's made to split. It's already sliced.
Sandwiches are sliced, and we never say, hey, bring in 4 sandwiches, and we'll just keep grabbing at the pieces until one of us feels like they get more than the others.
Well, I see sandwich platters at, like, meetings. There'll be, like, a platter of, like, cut-up sandwiches. Like in the boardroom or whatever upstairs, when there's, like, a bunch of dudes in there, they'll have, like, fucking split-up sandwiches.
Split-up sandwiches.
Yeah, it's like a hero or whatever, just
those
sliced.
Sandwiches are already down to bite size.
Yeah, they're split up like a slice of pizza. I've seen it.
I know exactly what you're talking about. You don't have to act like you're bringing some fucking madness. But would we say get us a thing of...
No, that's crazy.
Yeah, it wouldn't happen that way. The only the food we would do that is pizza. And then everybody, you know, watches Big Matty Ice just go to fucking town on it.
Well, he said he'd go to town on it. He couldn't even fucking finish one slice last time.
I think he did that to fuck with Fez. I think because I saw him eat 6 before.
He's a grown boy.
Would you rather go to, like, if we went out to dinner, do you like when it's family style food, or you like to get your own plate?
I like family style. Everybody gets a taste of everything. I think that's fun.
That's because you didn't even eat family style in your own family.
Oh, no. Terrible cook, my mother.
Was she?
Oh, really bad. Like, horrifically bad cook.
Robert, here's what we found out, because you ever notice Shade 45 is always stacked with pizza boxes?
Yeah.
Well, we found out from black people that black guys would rather order their own small pizza than a couple of large pizzas.
Really?
They do not like to share pizza.
I try to stay abreast with what's going on in the community.
Well, because of your hair. You need to know hair products alone.
Right. I had no idea this pizza thing was happening.
I didn't either till the other day.
Look at the garbage can outside Shade 45. There's just five or six individual small Domino's boxes in there filling it up.
So what if they're in New York where there is no small, medium, large? You just order a pie. They're all ordering pies?
They go to Domino's.
They just get Domino's.
They don't go
the only
and spend money on above Domino's.
They're just doing Domino's.
But they
$5
just,
for
yeah,
a pie.
Yeah, $5.
So is Domino's targeting black people then when they go, it's like three, if you order three medium pies, you get them for...
Yeah, you get shoes. No, all fast food targets black people.
Yeah. Well, I mean, McDonald's is blatant about it, but...
Yeah.
Wow. What? You'd think that they were such a, they're a community.
Well, here's
I mean, they like chilling together.
Yeah, maybe but they want to make sure that they get their part of it. It's, it's just that they don't see it as a communal... thing just in the same way is if you were eating a bowl of cereal, you wouldn't expect me to come over with a spoon and start eating with you. That would be considered nuts.
I guess, but slices, I feel like, are individual portions.
Yeah, but who's going to get the most? Some guys like to take their time eating, and they don't want to know that, let's say, somebody else eats faster. So they want to make sure I paid for it.
Right.
I'm getting mine.
Take your three slices up front.
Now, on the other hand, black people say that white people smell like wet dogs. Did you know that?
I didn't know black people say that about white people.
Oh, put in the Google and just put black people think white people smell like, and you'll see how fast it picks up.
The Ron and Fez Show on the Opie and Anthony Channel. Sirius XM. You've been warned.
Speaking of whacked out, we're going to do the dollar bet. I gave you 1,000,000 to 1 odds.
I'm going to owe you this dollar because I don't have a single one.
I'll probably have to owe you the million for a little bit, too, if I lose. Although I'm not even slightly worried about it. Fez, did you indeed cry last night at your shrink?
Chris Stanley? Congratulations, you've just lost a dollar.
That, I thought I was going to win 1,000,000.
Looks like somebody's been watching American Idol.
I feel like
and it was like making the announcement, very tense.
Nobody's watching American Idol.
What were you crying about, Fez?
Just a lot of things going wrong and just not getting
Could you
better.
Be more vague? Try to be as vague as possible when it's Fez time.
Just...
This and that.
Just things that I keep fucking up. The anger thing, getting so pissed off at the intern the other day. Things that have come from that. And just really feeling out of control. And talked about, you know, coming from the two places, from either fear or anger.
If this doesn't sound like the Paulo thing to you, it's
you
exactly the same. So what did your shrink say for you to do?
Well, again, she went back to changing the inner voice. I was crying a lot, and she was, like, trying to just chill me out. She said she would have stuff for me to do next week, and I even...
Coloring books?
It almost sounded like that.
Word jumble?
When she said exercises, and then, but I ended up staying an extra half hour, too, just because I was really having trouble pulling myself together. And just, like, where does the anger come from? And she had theories on that.
What are they?
Well, she said, it went back to
fucking
mother.
Fucking to be specific. It's your mom, right?
She said, angry still at my mother, but what I've done is everyone and every person in my life, from myself to the callers to everybody, I have turned into my mother. And she said, and then at one point, she said, you're your own mother now. And then she said, you're mad at your mother. So I said, am I my mother or am I still, or am I mad at my mother? She goes, you're both. She said, you're furious with yourself for being gay.
Can I tell you something? So far, I think this is the best shrink you've ever had.
Really?
I think it's the first fucking shrink telling you the truth.
She said, and...
You hate the realization that you are gay.
And I brought up that I go, I don't feel that way, but anytime something gay comes up, I instantly go to anger.
You're angry about gays, and you're angry about straight people not accepting gays, but you're also very angry with gays. And you're grossed out by gay sex.
Well, I told her, too. I go, I'm terrified of gay people. Like, you know, with the Grindr stuff or any of the websites that... And when I hear a story about some gay guy getting beat up or robbed or murdered, it terrifies me even more. And she said, well, that's where you're your mother, because when you don't do anything, explore being gay, and you stay idle, she said... That's you punishing yourself. You're punishing yourself for being gay because you're furious about being gay. And you're going to punish yourself because that's what your mother would do.
I think this woman's dead on.
So we spent a little over 90 minutes talking about that stuff. Mostly it was anger. So then the next step is to quit making everybody in my life my mother.
So is Popcorn his mother?
Including myself.
Yeah. Anybody that he disagrees with or disagrees with him becomes mom. And the weird thing is, in the case of, let's say, Popcorn, I think with Popcorn and the cat, Fez became the mother. It was very much like Psycho, the movie Psycho. And when he yells, and the way he treats people, and the way that he goes from this, from zero to like the meanest thing that he could ever say, you know, with full rage, is because his thing is, how do I react? Oh, like my mom reacted. How do I feel? Oh, like mom felt. I think the shrink is definitely on to you.
Yeah, that, and she put all that out there. She goes, that's how you were raised to react.
Yeah, and you haven't given it any thought since. That's the weird thing. Like, you still haven't looked back at that like an adult. When you look back at it, you look like a child. And I think that there was some kind of, like, thinking for you stopped a long time ago. It's why you don't see anything... more than one possible way. You don't sit down and perceive how the whole thing could be played out, because you're thinking like a child. Something's good, something's bad. And in the same way of a child is, if something's bad or I have a problem with something, if I'm not taking the temper tantrum, you know, because you're afraid, then you just stand still. That thing is, you know, is a big part. You wait things out like you would around an angry... The weird thing is, like, almost like an alcoholic patient, but it might have been an insane thing. Like, when I was sitting down with the Alan Alda stuff, knowing that I guess we'll play that next week.
Yeah.
He had a mom that had mental problems. But the weird thing is, he thought about it later as an adult. You're still trapped back there as a little kid.
Yeah, another thing she got into, which I didn't think about this with my mother, she said, you take everything so personally, whether it's a call to the show, everything with you is a personal attack. And she said, you took it really personally, what your mother did as a child. And I had never thought of this before. She said, it wasn't personal with your mother. You thought your mother didn't like you. You thought your mother targeted you. It didn't matter who was your mother's kid. That was going to happen. That was the way she was. That was the way she dealt with kids. Because my brothers got it, too. My sister got it. But she goes, it wasn't personal, and you have to quit taking it personally.
Didn't you remember we just talked about this like a week ago? Where I said, we all got hit like kids, but it didn't matter as much to us. Or I said, if I knew I was going to do some bad stuff, but I wanted to do it, I thought I would just take the corporal punishment as part of, you know, like when the check comes due.
Yeah, and I brought that up to her, and I said, you know, other people say they got hit. They had angry parents that went off the deep end from time to time. There, you know, she goes, it was different for you. You took it so personally where other people realized later in life what was going on.
So what keeps you from looking back as an adult? What keeps you from thinking as an adult? That's your big thing.
Yeah, I think it's because the anger gets in the way so quickly and my feelings get hurt so quickly that I just either go despondent or rage and just end up blinding myself to everything where I can't think about it.
But what do you get out of that? You got to get something out of it.
I think I probably feel, if I get angry like that, I probably feel justified.
Dave, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Yes. I'd like to know two things, actually. First of all, why does Fez keep running down to Florida every time he gets a day off if this is what's going on with his mother?
We brought that up to Fez before, and what is it about you? You still want to be a good son. Now, since your dad died more than ever, right?
Yeah, now it's weird. It's like that I would always feel guilty if I missed a holiday there to begin with. And then once my dad died, like the guilt over that old woman is like even more multiplied.
What do you get out of calling her that old woman?
No, I don't mean it as an insult. I mean,
I didn't ask you that. I go, what did you get from referring to your mom? What is that, like, sense of power? Is that like a little put down?
No, it wasn't a put down. I meant it as it's still going on. That the guilt feeling is still going on. Even now, as an old lady.
But beyond that, you do that whether sometimes this old woman or that old woman. Is that, I'm just saying, does that give you a feeling of, you know, I'm taking her down a peg?
It probably does, where it's something, if I say that, then maybe she doesn't feel as powerful to me still.
But she is powerful to you, huh?
Yeah, and trust what the caller just asked, I brought that up to the therapist,
mm-hmm.
and she said, you're still trying to grab some acceptance that you are never going to get.
Well, the fact
or at least never feel.
Yeah, I was going to say that. I mean, the fact is, your mom may accept you, but you're still playing out the same fucking little kids games.
I'm still playing out the same little kids games because I know, like, if I had a boyfriend and took him down for Christmas to Florida, that wouldn't be accepted. So I'm keeping myself in the role of what's acceptable.
Yeah,
punishing
but
myself.
But you don't have a boyfriend anyway. You know what I mean? Like, you don't know what would be accepted and what it wouldn't. I mean, why play that out? Or why would that matter to you, whether or not she accepts it? I never understand, why does it matter to you what somebody else thinks? They're not living the way you're living anyway. Here's Charles in Connecticut. You're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, I don't mean to take the show back, but I need some historical context because I used to listen to it, the show a while ago, and I feel like I missed a chunk where Fezzy, you just kind of like went off the deep end because you were like this super active part of the show, really funny, really a major contributor, and now it seems like whenever I turn on the show, you know, we're diagnosing your latest problem.
Yeah, I mean, that happened several years ago when I first started having, like, panic attacks on the air and the first times I locked up.
He's saying that's when he started to realize... When he started to realize he was gay for real...
Yeah.
...is when these other things started to happen. And that's when... Yeah.
I see, and that was a few years ago.
No. No, that was going... That goes back 7, 8 years. Maybe even more. Maybe 9 years.
Okay. Well, I feel for you, buddy.
Jim, Alabama, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, Fezzy. It sounds like there's some progress being made here, which is good. And it also sounds like by going down to Florida that you just hit on, you're trying to atone for something that seems to be fruitless. But with this seemingly, I guess, breakthrough, are you just hearing what she's saying and reacted upon it, or do you actually think she's dead on and believe what she's hitting on?
The stuff last night, I had a lot of trouble accepting that I hate being gay, because I feel like I felt like I got past that shame, but I obviously haven't. So I did eventually have to agree with her. So that part was really hard to accept.
Yeah, there's a lot of it that I always hear in the arguments where a lot of people, being that number is like 3% or whatever it is, it's not part of their life. So if they're not pro-gay, like, you know, rah-rah, it always seems that they're labeled as anti-gay, and it just seems very like an angry approach to people that it's really not their life. I understand people call and bust your chops and guilty as charged, but, you know, it's done in love and fun and, you know.
It's an angry approach, but when I'm screaming, you know, at people about slurs and not to be homophobic, I'm screaming at myself. I'm screaming at my mother.
Lynn, go ahead.
It just seems like Fez is, like, stuck in, like, his old normal. And, you know, just your mom's blood doesn't mean you have to stay in that, you know? I mean, it's just so angry and so, like, you know, because you're, you know?
Yeah, I know what you mean. And anger will come up on me really, really quick. Walking down the sidewalk, I'll end up just furious with somebody, you know, walking a dog and taking up the whole sidewalk. And it's the same damn anger as whether it's a gay issue or a gun issue or yelling at the intern. It's all that same level of anger. Which is just ridiculous. And it's not helping at all, that's for sure. It's not healthy.
Why not instead try to figure out what is healthy about it instead of putting the whole thing down? If you go around and do this, you must have some positive intention. So just to push it away and act like there's no positive intention to it is going back to playing the same games. It's you now trying to play good little boy again. What's good about walking around being angry with people? What's good about those things before you let go of it?
I think what that is if I get angry at somebody like taking up the sidewalk or being, you know, blocking the stairs on the subway, I think it's like a tiny chance to feel superior for a moment, because when I realized what was going on with the gay stuff and I really was really down about it and was never ever going to talk about it, was never going to admit it, that's for sure, was never going to act on it even more, and it just felt like everyone was better than me for not being gay. Everyone's opinion was better than mine for not being gay.
I'm going to help you here. You're not gay. I don't think you have to worry about the gay thing at all. You don't do anything that's gay.
No, I don't do anything that's heterosexual either.
Yeah. So what? Why do you need to belong to groups?
I think I think I've just been trying to prove it to myself.
Prove what to yourself?
Prove to myself that, A, I'm gay, and B, that I have no problem being gay.
Why don't you just say now, you're not gay, and take that pressure off you?
I could say, it's gonna, again, take some convincing, but I haven't done anything gay. I'm not gay. I haven't done one gay thing. I haven't had a gay act in my life. I haven't met boys. I've been attracted to guys. I know what I look at online, but it's not being a gay man in America. So until something does actually happen, I guess I'm not gay. I still want to defend gay people. I mean,
you don't
I
have
think,
to. You don't have to. You're not helping them by defending them. You're better off just voting and letting them work out their own thing. Because I never see them going, I need someone to defend me. I never run into that.
No.
So you don't even have to defend them for right now. If anything, you probably want to make amends to Popcorn, right?
I would like to apologize to Popcorn.
Well, he's not here.
No.
Is he here today?
No.
No, he's not here.
You got to think of something for him. That mother stuff that you did with him. You hate his mom the way you hate your own mom.
He likes cigarettes.
I thought whiskey. He smoked a pipe.
Whiskey, too. He likes whiskey.
He's out of that fucking pipe thing. Yeah. That was just one day he thought that I would like him better if we both smoked something weird.
He likes Marlboro Reds.
Here's Sean. Sean, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, boys.
Yeah.
Going back to how Fezzy sees everyone else as being his mother. Ron, I also think that he kind of looks at you as being his father. I mean, you give him beatings one after another, and he never really seems to get angry with you.
No, he never does. I always try to test it to see when he's going to stick up, and he never does. Even, you know, now admitting the, okay, I'm not gay. Just that quickly to agree with it. It's kind of interesting.
It's weird.
Well, I would like that. I guess that pressure off.
The pressure of what?
Of being worried constantly about proving that I'm gay and that I love being gay. That I have no problem with myself being gay.
So you would rather say, I pushed that aside and I'm not gay, and now you won't have to deal with it anymore?
I want to push it aside in the effect of, until something happens that I'm gay, then I'm just not going to worry about that.
So I guess no float for you this year.
Oh, God, I still want to be in the parade.
Why would you be in the parade? You just made the thing, I'm not gay.
All right, now I'm getting really conflicted again.
All because you wanted to...
Holy shit!
Because you wanted to ride in a float?
No, but I love the gay parade, and I love the pride march. And I love being part of that. Those are days when being gay was absolutely an amazing feeling. Where it didn't have that paranoia feeling of everything feeling against me.
Because there was a lot of people to agree with you.
Yeah, yeah.
Yay. I'm in the majority. Yay. The majority agrees with me. So what I'm saying, what I'll never have to think about as well. You should probably come out. You know, we have a lot of parades here in town. You probably should come out as that every week. Be a Puerto Rican one week, a Greek.
Oh, West African.
Yeah, part of the Caribbean. Chris, you're on the Run of Fez Show.
I think there's two things going on here. I think that Fez doesn't like women because he doesn't like his mother. And I think that's part of the reason why he thinks he's gay. The second thing is that if Fez really is gay, I think that he realizes he's turned into his mother and he doesn't want to subject another person to that, and that's why he hasn't acted on it.
I understand the turning into my mother part, but I've never thought of not subjecting somebody else to my mother because I've done that plenty of times.
But you don't feel guilty about getting into a relationship with somebody and having your mother projected onto somebody else like your mother treated you?
Oh, I've brought that up before where I would be worried to death about getting in a relationship and ruining it just from, you know, like jealousy things that I've seen my mother do, you know, which I've done before. Yeah, of just the neediness. Yeah, I would really be concerned about that.
Yeah, I think it just boils down to confidence. I think that you'll find it one day and you'll get out there, Fez. So good luck with it.
I think you finally got a good shrink. Finally.
She's talking some sense. This is pretty fucking crazy, though.
What's that?
The confliction of the sexuality.
There hasn't been any.
Yeah.
He hasn't made a fucking sexual move in a half century. I don't understand why we'd act like that's crazy today. You would have normally said this was crazy when he was 17, 18, 20, 25. By now, it's like worrying about an old aunt who's a spinster. You just don't give it much thought. Everybody does what they want to do. That's the way I see it. He's doing what he wants to do. He just doesn't accept it. John, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, Ron. Hey, Fezzy. I'm just curious, Fez, what you're going to plan on doing with these realizations you're having. I mean, it's good that you're kind of breaking through with this new therapist a little bit, but you don't take any real action. And I don't think, you can't outthink certain problems like this. And I'm just curious, what are you planning on doing anything different? I mean, get something concrete down finally.
Well, I'm going to obviously stick with this woman. With this therapist, and she said we can start working, now that we've talked a lot of this through. The first couple sessions was just like a lot of background stuff where she tries, where I have to remind her of who's who and stuff. And it sounds like she really wants to start working next week. She, was telling me to try my best to change the voice in my head, especially in the morning. And just try to say some positive things. And if I can't do that, just, say that she, think about her saying positive things.
What's the one thing you like to do now?
Quit being so... quit panicking over every situation.
All right, so I said, what's the one thing you like to do?
Oh.
And you said quit panicking over every situation. What's something you like to do?
Let's see. I like to watch television. I like to watch the wrestling. It's
Isn't
weird.
That on television?
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay. So now we're going to break down every part of television. I like to watch the weather.
Oh, yeah.
Like to watch sports. Like to watch. Do you have anything that you like to do?
Yeah, it's been so long. I used to like to read comic books, and I haven't done that in a long time.
Well, you made a thing that you would never read another comic book. Remember?
Yeah. Yeah, after the Joker shootings.
Yeah. Corey, you're on the Ron and Fez show.
Hey, actually, I just thought about this. When I hear Fez talk, I hear a lot of similarities between some of the stuff he thinks that I think. And I think, like when he says that he kind of feels like, part of something when he's at a parade, I think that's exactly what it is. It's not necessarily that he's going, for the gay part. It's just I'm kind of like Fez. I'm a lonely person, too. And I think he just wants to kind of feel that he's with somebody and with a group of people, and there's other people that are like him who are kind of for the common, the common good for certain things.
The thing that I believe is that he does love it when the majority says, we've made a decision, because before that, he used to like going to church, not because he had any of his own personal connections to God. But when everybody else said, here's a personal connection to God, he could say, me too. And when he was Republican, he loved that because everybody would vote for Reagan and then he could say, me too. And then when he was with Obama, he likes when his guy wins because that means he's in the majority. He loves to be in the majority because somebody else has made the decision. His favorite thing to do on the show is what?
Be down on people. Jump in.
Well, that's to be second on the beatdown, yeah. He didn't like his own thing as when he got carried away with it. But his favorite thing to do on the show was the live read. Because somebody else has written this up and said, here's the way this has to be done. And that's a very comforting thing. Oh, I got this. Sales gave me this from the client. I can read this perfectly.
This is what the client wants.
Yeah. And that feels good. Here's Matt. Matt, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, I have a theory. I think Fez only thinks he's gay because subconsciously he wants to hurt his mother, and he knows that by being gay, that would hurt his mother in the worst way. I don't think he actually likes cocks, but I do think Pepper wants some Davey Mac dick.
There does seem to be a thing where you and Dave have gotten uncomfortably weird together.
There is a weirdness going on, but I assure everyone, we're straight.
I was playing, I was listening to you guys the other night, and a friend of mine came over, and I had it on, and he goes, are you listening to two guys in the steam room? And I go, no, it just sounds that way.
Wow. That's what they thought when they heard.
Yeah.
That's a sports show. Did you tell it to your friend?
Hmm?
You tell it to your friend that's a sports show they were listening to?
My friend happens to be a renowned psychiatrist and knows exactly the underlinings and underpinnings that's going on between you two. Jake, you're on the Ron and Fez Show.
Hey, Fez.
Hey.
I think you should do yourself a favor. From now on, just listen to Ron. He told you for years to dump that other shrink. And to hear you have a logical, articulate, lucid conversation about your current shrink and not sound...
And this could have all happened 2 years ago.
Yeah,
This all could have happened years ago because that other shrink wasn't bringing up anything.
He was just letting him go in there cry. And
letting
him
go
him
in and cry and then saying, you're going to be okay. And then, you know, maybe letting Fez snap on him a little bit. But it was like having a weird fantasy time. Nothing was actually being done in terms of work. Nothing was ever about moving forward.
Yeah. That guy was just filling a slot on his schedule. What an asshole.
Here's Kevin. Kevin, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, what if?
Hey.
I got to tell you, whenever Fez does a live read, I go out and order that product. I mean, I've got Dollar Shave Club now. I've got Pajama Grand. I've got Steven Singer Jewelers. I'm going to get a Gold Dip Rose. So, good job, Fez. Way to sell some product.
All right. Just don't confuse the rose with the razor.
What about the hopper?
I like the hopper because you can get every show that was on last night.
Yeah.
In the meantime, I can't find one to watch.
You DVR everything.
You DVR everything. And then how do I watch it? When do I find time? Because won't I be DVRing everything tonight?
This DVR is so good at fucking DVR shit in the future. It's like a fucking production studio.
Jesus Christ.
Yeah, it's the fucking hopper.
Hey, Purple Guy, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, I got a song for Fezzy.
Good.
My radio name is Fez White Ray. I've never taught my cat to say cook gay. I'm gonna spend my life with Stalker Patty. That's why I hate myself for being gay.
Thanks for the song. I prefer ex-boyfriend.
Danny, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Ronnie B, what's going on, buddy? First time caller.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, Fez, I just wanted to try to, you know, pass down a little knowledge to you. Your circumstance is very unusual. Not many people have to sit for 4 hours a day and have random people that they've never met in their life before just call them the most hatred, you know, just spew hate at them without ever having really meet the person. And, you know, you thought you'd be like, oh, you go caveman. It only took you 2 seconds to go caveman. And you say it. But I don't think you really mean it. You got to understand that these people that are calling you up and calling you directly calling you a faggot have more problems than you have currently. and you got 80 years of life. You're halfway through. It's time to start enjoying it, man. I've only been listening to the show for 3 months, and I can just tell that you're a great person. I think you're a great guy, and you gotta take these assholes with a grain of salt, man, because they got it well worse than you do, buddy.
Thanks. I mean, it goes back to what she said last night of just not everything is personal.
You don't think they're personal when they do that?
I think they're personally mad at me. You know, maybe it's personal for them, but I don't need to take it on personally. Like the other day when I made some lump reference to they as all the callers in general.
Mm-hmm.
Where, you know, you've explained to me in the past, it's not one entity. It's not, you know, one thing out to get me. It's not every caller is the same person. Where I just go to a place of everything just, you know, it's one big mob after me and paranoia.
Just be careful that you're not just trying to good boy the answers back that you heard from the other thing. Make it your own thoughts, you know? Think about it. Rather than going, hey, I've heard this thing and now I completely 100% agree. Find your own thing. Like you were talking about Chris Stanley having his own philosophy. The weird thing that is, Chris, in his own way, he works his program. And you saw his driving factor today, right? He brought it up.
Right.
What's that?
Where he was saying it was about money, wasn't it?
No, he doesn't want to be homeless. That's his big fear. So he's going to get up in the morning, go to work. He's going to pay the bills that he has to pay.
That's right.
But that's all done as an absolute, you know, he doesn't have dreams of thriving. You know what I mean? He doesn't think to himself, I'm going to, you know, live in a fucking penthouse overlooking Central Park.
Nice.
He's like, I cannot be homeless. That is my focus.
That would be pretty cool.
All right, just getting about ready to wrap this one up. Sean Dunn, who is a buddy of ours, has done the show several times, just won a big directing prize at Tribeca. Very, very proud of
awesome.
Him.
Awesome, for Oxiana.
We just also had some nice mozzarella cheese and some cigars.
Oh, hell yeah.
Thanks to a gentleman who stopped by unmasked.
That's Rich.
Very, very cool.
And he gave us a nice picture. He drew this of Robert Downey Jr.
That's a fantastic drawing.
Hell yeah.
I want you to put that up as maybe one of the Paulo things.
Okay.
Drew, you're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, guys. Ronnie, great interview as usual. Amy Schumer is pretty fantastic.
Yes, she is.
I would say that.
And that's it? You just said I would say that, and then you hung up. John, go ahead, buddy. You're on the Ron Fez Show.
Hey, Ron. Great interview as always. But what was wrong with the sound? It sounded like Amy was in a closet. You were in a gymnasium.
What? Are you being real, or are you just busting his balls?
I'm
going to have you work on the sound.
He hangs up.
A little bit for the next Unmasked. No Weekender, second week in a row. We will announce Monday the first responders for @AmySchumer. She has got her big show starting out. Looks like Paulo's going to topple the film industry right now.
His Kickstarter is going strong.
Yeah. It's going real strong. Filtered Excellence up over on the iBang. And we'll be back in here on Monday. Now, Monday, we are going to start something new on the Ron Fez Show. And I don't think anyone else has ever done this in team-oriented radio. But for now on, listeners of the Ron and Fez Show, if you bag your own groceries, you save some real money. So make sure you're here for that on Monday. It's going to be very, very exciting.
I bring my own bags.
And you're saving the environment. I bring cloth bags from home.
I go green. Who needs that plastic? Have a nice day. Kiss my ass.
I'm going brown for bark. I don't just think that the leaves should be the only thing mentioned. I'm a bark guy from way back. Do I find a song to end with every week, huh?
That's great.
See you guys back in here on Monday. Peace. Oh, wait to hear this out cue, too. It's really, really funny.
And that's the end of my show. Donk.